I never thought in a million years that I'd be leaving California and moving to Gatlinburg, Tennessee, but here I am. So right now I plan on building a tiny house, unique space compound that I want to put on Airbnb. And I have a couple of ideas of what I'm going to do. I'm going to build a 20-foot container home that hopefully I can...
Hi, my name is Rob, and I've got a unique obsession with building tiny homes. And the occasional tiny human. I also showcase my builds to the whole world on the Rob Built YouTube channel.
I'm your host, Rob.
A couple of months ago, me and my wife quit our six-figure jobs in California, packed up our bags, and moved across the country to Gatlinburg, Tennessee, to pursue the craziest dream of building a tiny house community.
Let's build a tiny house village.
But as it turns out,
there's a lot of coordination that's needed whenever you're planning a tiny treehouse, apparently.
It takes a village to build a tiny home village. So I had to call in a few reinforcements.
Hey, is that bear poop?
Say something funny.
Shoot. I'm Clint. I've known Rob since college. I've been business partners with him for the past 4 years, and I am very excited to build a tiny house village in Gatlinburg, Tennessee. There is nothing like this in the general vicinity, and with the traffic that the Smoky Mountains National Park gets and Gatlinburg being in the part of that, I think the people around here are ready for a unique and amazing experience. I think Rob's the right guy for this, not only because of his proven track record, not only because of his proven track record with his glam sites in Williams, Arizona, or the Joshua Tree projects, or his Shenandoah or West Virginia projects, but also because he's got the creative know-how and the work ethic and drive to see something like this through. People are so accustomed to the cheesy paradise cabins, the bear-themed cabins, and we're looking to bring the tiny movement to the heart of the Smoky Mountains. Smashing, baby.
I'm kind of like Tennessee's most eligible bachelor right now.
That's how it usually is. There's always like two inspectors and one guy actually working.
I'm Johnny, one of Rob's partners on his previous builds in Joshua Tree, and I'm the foreman on this project. How I still have all my fingers, I'm not sure.
If we have to start this from scratch, I quit.
I dropped my life as a software engineer and investor out in Joshua Tree and said, hey, let's do this. We're doing something that's never been done before in the Smoky Mountains. We're hoping thousands of people are gonna be staying here once it's done. I'm super excited of what's gonna happen this year and following years when we build a million of these.
I'm doing stuff. All right, should we go build an A-frame?
Sure, let's do it.
I remember talking to my wife and pitching her on the idea of packing up our cush life in California and moving to Tennessee, and she said, you're crazy.
No.
Okay.
I said, well, you know what's even crazier than that is working 9 to 5 and working for somebody else and not building something for ourselves. So we're out here. I had to call people that I knew could help me get this job done because I knew I couldn't do this alone. So I called Johnny, my foreman. He leads all of my projects all over the country. Clint, one of my original business partners when I got into the short-term rental game.
Every breath I take is like 30% gnat.
I called on them because I knew I couldn't do this alone. We're on 50 acres and I'm looking to do something that's never been done before. So come along as I build a few tiny places, unique spaces, and everything in between.
We built the A-frame. Just like degraded so fast.